Hi everybody, this is Sinisha from XOAP, and today I'm going to talk about the PowerShell App Deployment Toolkit. Let's go! So let's have a look at the toolkit. To download the toolkit, we switch to psappdeploytoolkit.com. You will have a nice overview of the features here, and if you like, you can also have a look at the available functions. To download it, we switch here on the left side to the navigation item, are being redirected to the GitHub repo of the toolkit, and here you can see the latest release, and then just click on download. I already did that and opened the toolkit up front. The first things you see, there is a good documentation being delivered as well as PDF. We also have some examples here where you can have a look at how actually things have to be configured or done to deploy, for example, an Office package. But the main thing we have to look at is this toolkit folder. And if I open it up, you can see here is the deploy application PS1 file. And that is the main function we have to adjust to get an application installed. So if we start from the top, you can here see the help for this script. And if we move forward, we have a parameter area. These are the standard parameters that come with every package, and you can adjust that if you like. And if we go further below, we see a variable declaration where you put in stuff like vendor, application name, version, language, and also the author name if you like. And then if we go further, we get to the first phase, and that's the installation phase. So the PowerShell App Deployment Toolkit has three phases that it delivers. It's an installation phase, an uninstallation phase, and a repair phase. And each of those phases is again divided into three phases, sub-phases. So for example, we have here the pre-installation phase. Here you could do something like copying sources over to Node. Maybe the installer requires that it's somewhere on the C drive. So you could copy things over, and in the next step, in the installation phase, you could then run the actual installation. And in the post-installation, you could clean everything up again to save some space on the client. And the same applies to the uninstallation phase and the repair phase. That's just a rough overview. So the next thing you need to know is there is also an executable being delivered that basically supports the same parameters as the script does. It's just here to make things a little bit easier. For example, if you have System Center in place and you want to run the installations, you don't have to specify like the PowerShell command and then the script behind it. You can just use the deploy application exit to simply start the installation. The next things that are important is the files folder that is empty currently and the support files folder. These are the locations where you put in your source files. So files is for source files, and everything that supports the installation, like a transforms file, a license file, or whatever, can be put into this support files folder to have some sort of organization. And now let's dig a little bit deeper into the actual toolkit in where you can find and adjust things for your own needs. So the first thing is this banner. So you can take this banner, adjust it with your company name or whatever you want to put inside to show the users when an installation is taking place, maybe the company name, for example. If I go back to the website and flip here over to those screenshots, you can see some examples of UI interface items that can be shown during the installation, if you like it. But you can also run completely silent installation. So that is something you can adjust here with this banner. The next thing you can adjust is a general configuration of the complete package. So things like, where are the log files stored? Are they being compressed? How to how to install MSI packages, for example, which parameters to use, and you can adjust it to your own needs. The only thing you have to know is this is done on a package level. So if you define it here, copy the complete folder for another package and make adjustments there, then it's always only for this one package. The next thing you should know is the toolkit extensions file. So if you are missing something from the various functions that the toolkit delivers, you can add those custom functions here. So the main reason is because this is a large script, and if the version changes, most of the changes are being done there. And you don't want to have the risk that if you adjust something there to your own needs, that it gets overwritten or that you have to like refactor everything. So the easiest thing would be to add functions, customized functions here. And because everything here is PowerShell, you can also add anything that's like based on PowerShell. So you can write your custom functions and put them here. The next thing you should know is there's also a PowerShell-based help file here. So when you're on the command line, you can run the script here to get like a small interface UI with all the available functions. And you can then read more about required parameters, for example, or what functions are there when you're using the PowerShell directly. Other things are related to like PNG, showing an icon file for the toolkit that you can adjust. And the last item here is the main function file that I already mentioned and where all the functions are integrated. And how do you start actually implementing a new package? What you have to do is you have to copy this complete files folder here, copy it, just paste it here, and then you rename it to whatever you want to install, maybe Adobe Reader or whatever. Small typo, Adobe Reader. And then you start like adjusting the deploy application PS1 file, put in all the source files you need, and from there on you can proceed with your packaging process. But that's basically a rough overview of all the items that are out there, and that should maybe show you a little bit of what needs to be done here to get a package up and running. And in the next videos I will show you how to use the PSAP deployment toolkit with XOAP package wizard, how to create some packages, and some more advanced use cases. So stay tuned. See you soon. Bye bye.